We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Minnesota Twins and the New York Yankees. Striding in, Jorge Polanco. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit weakly back to the mound. And there's one away. Up next for Minnesota, Josh Donaldson, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. One out, nobody on. Outside 2-1. Very mild temperatures as we begin tonight. 58 degrees here at first pitch. Strike taken as the curveball drops into the bottom part of the zone.
Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. Last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count, 3-2.
Now it will be the Minnesota DH. Nelson Cruz, first chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. 1-2 as the changeup had him out in front there. That misses. It's to 2-2 now with two away here in the top of the first. Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Twins DH. Eddie Rosario would be next if they can keep this inning alive. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Right fielder looking up, and that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. To the plate now, Eddie Rosario. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run.
Threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 2-1 home. High in the air out towards shallow right. Cave is in a few steps as he takes it for the first out. Digging in now for the Yankees, Luke Voit. He'll get to take his first cuts here. One and two now as that one's fouled off. And 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Full count now, 3-2. Back up the middle. And that finds its way into center for a one-out base hit. In now, Aaron Hicks. Line to the right side. In there, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. Into the box, Clint Frazier. It's 1-2.
That's a well-placed fastball right there, just off the outside. If you can get guys to expand the strike zone and go after that pitch, you're going to have a lot of success. No luck that time, though.
Got him. Stepping into the box, Torres, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. He's set. The 2-2. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall. A run in. Here's a second runner around third. A tag, and he's safe. They've taken the lead. So now to the plate, Mike Tauchman. Skied in the air to straightaway left.
Chasing after it is Rosario.
He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. Second inning set to go, and A-Ray Adrianza will be the next to bat. And a curveball here. Good pitch, but a better take, and it's to 2-1 now. Curveball misses here, so a good hitter's count now to 3-1. Hit well on the ground to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and the leadoff man set down to start the second. The next twin up, Miguel Sano. A two-ball, one-strike count to the Twins' first baseman.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Here now the 2-2. Grounded to short. And that's through for a hit.
The center fielder, number 25, Byron.
At the plate now, Byron Buxton. And there's ball two now. Buxton ahead in the count, 3-3.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in this zone, or do you just pitch around them?
Here's the payoff pitch. Ground ball left side. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
Batting it, the right fielder, Jake Cave.
At the plate, Jake Cave. 1-2.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
Had him fooled as he swings through the curveball. Two down. Sliding into the box, Ryan Jeffers. Twos all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Shoots this one over to first. Reined in. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Next for New York, Gary Sanchez. Count still full, 3-2. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. At the plate, Brett Gardner. Bases are empty, one man out. Here's a foul ball left side, and that'll move it to 1-2. And he struck him out as well, so the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are two away.
The third baseman.
Now in the box, Miguel Andujar. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. Count is 1-2 now. Here's the pitch. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Top of the third set to get underway, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Jorge Polanco. A ball and two strikes to the Twins shortstop. Left side, Andujar brings it in. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Here now the 2-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Full count still. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. And it's fouled away. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number 3. There's ball 4. Here's Nelson Cruz now, and he's off to a hot start in this one. Homered his first time around.
The last at-bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Count moves to a ball and 2 strikes now. The 1-2 pitch. And oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning. So here's the cleanup hitter, Eddie Rosario. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. Here it comes on 1-1. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Buxton is in his tracks now. One down. Digging in for his second at bat, Luke Voit. He reached on a single in his first try. One out, nobody on. This ball will be chopped foul. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And this is swung on and missed. His 5th strikeout already, and there are 2 gone in the inning. Coming to the plate now, Aaron Hicks. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. Two balls and 2 strikes to Hicks now. The 2-2. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. At the plate, Aure Adrianza, as we begin the top of the 4th. A 1-1. Misses, ball 2.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at-bat. One might be coming right here.
All even now, 2-2. Now here's the pitch. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Popped him up. And he'll indeed make the play in foul territory for the first down. So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. A base hit in his first trip. Count remains 2-2. Pitch on the way. Bottom dropped out on him, and that's a strikeout. And the throw is made to record the 2nd out of the inning. Here's Byron Buxton now. 1-for-1 after a single his first time up. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Jake Cave would be next. Ripped on the ground to first. Right to him. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Ready to go in the bottom of the 4th. And standing in is the DH, Clint Frazier. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Cave is over to his left as he snags this one for the first out of the inning. So the bases are empty with one man gone.
And that will bring up Gleyber Torres.
Yankee shortstop behind in the count 1-2.
Hey, you think back to the early innings right there. You thought this guy would have been hitting his showers. A credit to him. He's been able to regroup, find his mechanics, and find a way to stay in this game.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Just hung in there on that one. Hit on the ground to third. And that's the second out. Now to the plate, Mike Tauchman comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Both clubs with 3 hits in the ballgame. A ball and 2 strikes.
One ball, 2 strikes.
Grounder down the line at third. Donaldson's there. And a close play at the bag, but a good stretch by the first baseman got the out, and the inning is over. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And next it'll be the outfielder, Jake Cave. The 1-1 home. High and deep down the left field line, and this will wind up a foul ball. Even at 2 balls and 2 strikes, here's the pitch. Pulled toward right center field. LeMahieu is calling for it. 1 out. Riding in once again, Ryan Jeffers. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A little bit outside, 2-1. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now. On the ground to the right side. LeMahieu gets to it, and the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Jorge Polanco. A couple of ground outs on his batting line in 2 trips so far. 2-1 now to the Twins' leadoff man. Now a check swing, but he does manage to hold up in time. Ball 3. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Throw on to Voit, takes care of him, and the inning is over. Bottom of the inning now, and now it'll be the catcher, Gary Sanchez. And oh, he can't get out of the way of that one, so the leadoff man will be on to open the frame. So stepping in, Brett Gardner, 0-for-1 after he took a look at strike 3 in his first plate appearance.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the 2 strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
But no real shot at 2 as he's safe easily at first.
The third baseman, Miguel.
The 1-2 is laid off for ball 2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Now a move over to first, and he'll dive back in. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Hard hit ball to second. That's through for a base hit, and he's 1-for-2 now. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now batter, the second base.
Standing in now, DJ LeMahieu. Hit hard to the right side. Foul. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. Polanco takes charge out there and he stays with it for the second out. Ready once again, Luke Voit. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Fouled off. Two and two. Here it is. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And standing in is the veteran third baseman, Josh Donaldson. Hit sharply but foul down the right side. The 1-2. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that'll get on through into center field, so he's got himself a leadoff single. In now, Nelson Cruz. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land out there just foul. The 1-2 is taken for ball two.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Line towards center field. Hicks is there and he has it for the first out. Number 73 gets the call from the bullpen to pitch in relief.
The left fielder. Eddie Rosario
will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Taken, strike two called, and it's even at 2-2. From the belt, the pitch. Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. A swing, and this ball is blasted to right field. Nothing's going to keep this one in the ballpark. Into the second deck and gone. Stepping in now, Eury Adrianza. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Miguel Sano will be next. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four. Ready for another shot now. Miguel Sano, 1-for-2. He singled and struck out in two trips. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Swing and a line drive. But he just missed his extra bases. Here now the 2-2. He's at the knees and called strike three. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. Here's the 1-1. Well above the letters with the fastball that time. Fouled away. Three runs, five hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and coming forward is the switch hitting outfielder Aaron Hicks. The 1-1 home. His fastball that misses.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Tough one to call there, but it's ruled just above the zone.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ball game. Striding forward now, the Yankee cleanup hitter, Clint Frazier. He struck out and flied out, 0 for 2 so far. Hit on the ground out to short. He's right there, and there's out number 2. And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. He's working on a 1 for 2 game so far. Well outside with the curveball for a ball. Fastball is looked at for strike 2. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Chad Green is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 57.
So here's Jake Cave to the plate. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2. Now here's the pitch, and he fouls this one off. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 1-2 misses for the second ball. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Gardner is there. One out. Ready now, Ryan Jeffers. He's hitless in his 2 at-bats so far. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball, 2-2.
Big fastball is definitely this guy's MO coming out of the bullpen.
And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick 2 outs to start the 7th. And now back to the leadoff spot in the Twins lineup, stepping in Jorge Polanco. He'll swing it from the left side right here.
Well, this isn't his more accomplished side. As a general rule, he's a much better hitter from the right side, but they're looking for him to come through here, swinging the bat left-handed.
The 2-1 home. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball 3.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Hicks is under it, and that retires the side.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join us for the traditional double-digit.
Number 72 is ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager.
For Minnesota, number 72.
Last half of the 7th here, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Mike Tauchman.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by 1. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against the modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
Buxton, patrolling center, makes the play, one out.
Becker.
One gone here in the Yankee seventh, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two. Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there. Two away. Here's Brett Gardner now. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far.
Gardner.
The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Very tight ball game. 3-2 our score in inning number 7. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now. Miguel Andujar would be next. And it's fouled away. Lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game. Tyler Clifford takes the mound now, and it appears he's being brought in to face the right-handed batter who waits next.
Yeah, you usually don't hear the term righty specialist very often, but that's kind of how they're using him here, Matt. Most hitters have a harder time against pitchers of the same handedness, so we'll see if this move pans out.
Slapped hard the opposite way, and that'll get down for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. Into the box, DJ LeMahieu. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Skied into straightaway right. Right fielder giving chase. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Jonathan Holder has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 56.
Josh Donaldson digging in now. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Swung on and chopped down the line at first. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here. 3-2 pitch. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. LeMahieu onto the grass. He gets there, and that's the second out. Number 4 Minnesota hitter Eddie Rosario is working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
Well, you don't see this very often, Matty B. A 2-strike straight changeup, but this guy changeup is one of the best in the league. We'll see if he tries that different approach this time, and maybe if he gets to 2 strikes, try to use the fastball a little bit more than that straight changeup.
And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a 2-out base runner. Settling in now, Aure Adrianza. He's 0-for-2 with a walk thus far. And this is low, ball two. 2-1. Ball even at 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Trevor May is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 65.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Luke Voit. One. is swung on and missed for strike number two.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. Now at the plate, Aaron Hicks. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
Grounded back up the middle. And there are two away now. In now is the Yankees DH, Clint Frazier, who could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. Good idea with the change, but it's 2-1. Takes this the other way to right. A screaming base hit here, his first of the night. Throw into second. And he's going to make it there, barely, as he's into second base with a double. And now with the possible time run at second here, we're going to have a pinch runner as they try to get a little more speed out there. So now to the plate, Labor Torres. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. Coming to the plate now, Mike Tauchman. And a big at-bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the eighth. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Luis Sessa enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Here's Miguel Sano. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. The 2-1 home. Fouled off. The 2-2. Big swing by Sano and a ball sent to deep left field. And gone. An absolute bomb. Into the box now, Byron Buxton. Three balls and two strikes to the Twins center fielder. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fella? Swing and a long drive again. This one to deep center. Oh, but that'll be shy of the monuments as it hits off the wall. And they'll keep the pressure on here. He's in with a triple.
The batter, the right fielder.
At the plate now, Jake Cave. In the dirt and block behind the plate. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. From the belt, the pitch. Fastball right back to the mound. The flip on to take care of him at first as he fails to take advantage of the situation there, and that's the first out of the inning. So a big moment in the ball game here. Ryan Jeffers, although there are a couple of bases open, and we'll see if they think about working around him. And he misses 2-1. Hit out towards second. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Jorge Polanco. He flew out in his last at bat. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his.
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Taylor Rogers comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 55.
In now, Gary Sanchez. His prior history in this matchup, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. The 1-1 pitch. They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. And there's one gone to start the bottom of the ninth. So here's the veteran Brett Gardner. It was a walk in his last trip. Bases are empty, one man out. Hot shot down the line. A dive, but he can't make the play, and it's down the left field line. And this will find the wall deep in the corner. And he'll pull into second with one away. In now, Miguel Andujar. That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. Hit hard down the line. And he tries for the backhand reach at third, but he gets by the glove down the line. Throw to second, but he's in there. As a run also comes in to score, making it a two-run ball game. To the plate now, DJ LeMahieu. A bouncer up the middle. Scooped up on the first in time, and the Yankees are down to their final out now. Digging in to try it again, Luke Voit. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Last chance for the Yankees. Sinker, 3-2 now.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk you, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
He lays off, and that's outside, ball four. They're at the corners now here with two away. Stepping in, Aaron Hicks, and they're runners at the corners now. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder, and the Twins have advanced. They're headed to the AL Championship Series.
Well, they know their work is nowhere close to being finished, but they've handled their business so far, winning here to punch their ticket to the next round and a possible trip to the World Series. Well done.
Well, we watched a really solid starting pitching performance, kept the opposition at bay, and as a result, he's our top player of the game.
Yeah, I thought he pitched really well. He wasn't necessarily dominant, but turned in a good, solid effort and definitely was a factor in the win here.
For the left-hander Dan Plesac, Mark DeRosa, and our entire crew, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been the American League Division Series.
The final line score for our ball game tonight, for the victorious Twins, 5 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. For the Yankees, 3 runs on 8 hits, 1 error. They left 9 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 9 minutes. Our paid attendance here tonight at